bats, jack-o'-lanterns, ghosts, and skeletons. Yes, the spooky season upon us once again. Greetings, everyone. Gather around. It is time for the Crunchyroll Halloween Spooktacular Special Extravaganza Part 2. Back at it again, it's your trusty host, Dr. Frank and Tim. And tonight, we shall be doing another spooky kill count for one of my favorite manga and anime, Kiseiju, aka Parasite. Parasite was written and illustrated by Hitoshi Iwaki Sensei on Kodansha's Morning Open Zokan magazine and then monthly afternoon magazine from 1988 to 1995. By 2014, there were over 11 million copies in print, and on October 9th, 2014, the Parasite manga was adapted into an anime, animated by Studio Madhouse, called Parasite the Maxim. Right after the anime adaptation came the live action adaptation called Parasite Part 1, directed by Takashi Yamazaki, was released in theaters on November 29th, 2014, with Parasite Part 2 being released on April 25th the following year. Ooh. Parasite. What is it even about? Well, you see, it tells the story of Shinichi Izumi, a well-mannered high schooler who nearly gets his brain taken over by a tiny drillworm alien called a parasite. The process fails, but Shinichi ends up losing his right hand to the parasite who calls itself Migi. Izumi and Migi reluctantly team up, mostly because they're literally in this together, to survive and to ponder what it means to be human. What is society? And what is our purpose on this blue planet we call Earth? Now, with all of that said, let us begin. Let us go through all 24 episodes of Parasite and count the bloody deaths, kills, and murders. Oh, and of course, there will be non-stop spoilers, so if you haven't seen Parasite the Maxim, you can do that right now on Crunchyroll.com or check out the manga. Seriously, highly recommend it. Episode 1, The Metamorphosis. We start off with a loving husband and wife just staring at each other like normal married people do, and oh my god, his face! Chomp! Straight off the bat, not even 30 seconds in, we have two kills. Yes, you heard me correctly. Two kills. How is this possible, you ask? Since parasites kill their host when they take over, anytime we see a parasite, that counts as an automatic death for the human host. I'll also be counting the parasite death separately, so keep that in mind. Anyhow, bam, first death of the series is random husband, death by parasite infection, and then the second death goes to random wife, who is killed by the random husband's parasite. Now, we meet our main man, our main MC, the hero of Parasite, Shinichi Izumi. He's just a normal high schooler who happens to get a slinky worm stuck up his arm because he was asleep one night listening to ASMR, and then bam, he's got a whole being on his right arm. It has an eye, some hands, and talks. What the hell is this, Midori no Hibi? We also get two more deaths added to the kill list real quick. Bam, a third death goes to random street body, and wham, the fourth death is the laundry dude. Next day during brekkie, we get another kill added to the list. Wah bam, remember the random husband parasite? Well, he's back again, this time killing his own random daughter. R.I.P. On the way to school, bam, Shinichi come across a corgi. Nice. But it's eating another dog. Not nice. Anyhow, let's add corgi as our sixth death, death by parasite infection, and zam, the seventh death is this random dog that the corgi parasite is eating. The corgi parasite deems Shinichi and his right arm to be a threat, and so alien transformers knife fight begins, and stab, corgi parasite, death by Shinichi's new right hand. The fight ends and we get a weird transition to 2 days earlier. We see a poor lady being murdered by some dude laughing like the Joker, and of course, that's our eighth kill. Another stab ends the life of poor lady one, and that is episode one with 9 deaths. Actually, no, let's make it 11 deaths. Okay, I'm cramming in 2 more deaths, okay, but hear me out. On the third death and fourth death are pretty much confirmed to be parasite deaths, and the street body is from Osaka, while the laundry dude is from Miyagi. Those two places are 600 kilometers, or 373 miles apart, so I'm guessing there were two separate parasites. So, the 10th and 11th death goes to the Osaka parasite's host and the Miyagi parasite's host, death by parasite infection. Episode 2, The Devil in the Flesh. Episode 2 starts off with another poor lady, I'm gonna call her poor lady number 2, getting harassed by 3 Dumbos. Then a salaryman comes in to save the day. Or did he? He offers to walk the woman home, then bam, pipe to the head, and is that our 12th death? Nope. Surprise, the salaryman is a pirate. I was about to say pirate. The salaryman is a parasite. So a quick bam, and that's our 12th death with the salaryman, not by pipe, but death by parasite infection. So the parasite gives them the old slice, 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 and dice, and we get 4 deaths for the price of 1. The 13th, 14th, 15th, and 16th death go to the 3 bozos and the poor lady number 2. All death by salaryman parasite. Back to Shinichi, he decides to work together with his right hand, and the alien decides to name itself Miggy, which is Japanese for right, because, you know, it's the right hand, right, Miggy, no. You know, you get it. Anyhow, in school, Shinichi gets some buckets, then gets beat up by a classmate because he likes Murano and she likes Shinichi. I don't know how that's gonna help you with your relationship, but... Alright. Later, Shinichi and Miggy go for a little walk outside and end up coming face to face with this blondie puffy jacket man who turns out to be a human infected with the parasite. And you know what that means? Bam! We have our 17th death, the blonde puffy jacket man, death by parasite infection. Then, pretty much out of nowhere, the blondie parasite talks about how Miggy can relocate and live in its body and proceed to slice its own hand off. It tells Miggy to kill Shinichi and live with it. Miggy's like, nah, and slices the blondie parasite up, and yeah, slice. The 18th kill goes to the blondie puffy jacket parasite's death by being kind of an idiot. And that's episode 2 with 7 deaths. Let's move on to episode 3, Symphosium, I think. Over brekkie, Shinichi's dad mentions that there have been 84 mincemeat murders, and so right there, bam, we get 80 deaths. Yes, you heard me correctly, 80 deaths. Why 80 and not 84? I'm subtracting 4 deaths because deaths number 2, 3, 4, and 5 in this kill list are counted in the mincemeat murders. So this bit is real tricky, but I'm gonna try and count the parasite host deaths. Let's say one parasite will kill at least 3 people, you know, it's like breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So since there are 80 new killings, let's do a guesstimate of roughly 26 parasites. So wablam, add 26 more host deaths, all death by parasite infection. Back at school, Shinichi gets a shocker that the new math teacher is a parasite, so bam, let's add Tamiya Ryoko, the math teacher, to the kill count, death by parasite infection as well. After coming face to face, Shinichi and Ryoko meet at a cafe, and Ryoko brings the creepy Mr. A back. Bam, our 126th death, Mr. A, death by parasite infection. In this cafe meetup, Ryoko drops 2 bombshells. 1, she's had the big sex with Mr. A, good job I guess, and 2, that she's pregnant with a human child. Dun dun dun! Next day in school, Mr. A just says f*** it and decides to kill Shinichi. He busts in school and slice slice 2 teachers dead, death by Mr. A. The school is evacuated and the episode ends with a face-off. Shinichi and Miggy versus Mr. A. Will Mr. A kill our main hero? Will Shinichi stab Mr. A with a chair leg? And will Miggy ever see Shinichi have sex? Find out next week on Parasite The Maxim. Episode 4, Tangled Hair. We start this episode with a standoff. Miggy plans to go on the defense while Shinichi will be on the offense because Mr. A doesn't think Shinichi is shit. He won't even see him as a threat. The battle is underway and Shinichi stabs Mr. A with a chair leg and Mr. A stumbles away. The dying Mr. A decides to jump into Ryoko's body to stay alive and finds her in the science lab when kablooey, we have our 129th death with Mr. A. Death by Ryoko, and more specifically, death by explosion. Few days pass and the school committee finds out that Ryoko has a child and she doesn't know her husband. They bring this up and Ryoko just straight up goes, alright, I'm done being Tamiya Ryoko, and walks out. At night, Tamiya Ryoko's mother goes to check up on her daughter. She sees the Ryoko parasite and instantly knows that isn't her Ryoko. You know what's coming next? Splat! We have the 130th kill with Ryoko's mother. Death by Tamiya Ryoko's parasite. The next day, Shinichi learns that his parents are planning a little trip to the countryside. Fearing for their safety due to the parasite pandemic, but unable to tell what the hell a parasite even is, Shinichi just tells them no. Some classic mother and teen son drama ensues, and we get a flashback that shows us that Shinichi's mother got scars trying to protect Babby Shinichi. That'll be important later. After some more parent and child talks, mom and dad decide to go on their vacation. Episode 5, The Stranger. So, episode 5, we see a car driving on by and learn the importance of seatbelt use. And cars, bam, our 131st kill is this car crash lady. Not death by car crash, but actually death by parasite infection. Anyway, the car crash parasite realizes the body's done for, and splat, it's the 132nd kill with car crash dude. Death by car crash lady parasite. The next morning, Shinichi gets in a little hostage situation, a little beatdown, and meets a girl named Kana, who has the ability to sense parasites. Fade to the countryside, we see Shinichi's dad and mom having a good time until bam, the worst death in this kill list. Our 133rd death is Nobuko Izumi, Shinichi's dear mother. Death by car crash parasite. RIP to mom. Shinichi gets a phone call from his father later, who gives him a cryptic message about mom and how he'll get revenge on the monster. Distraught, Shinichi passes out. The next day, Migi senses a parasite is nearby. Filled with rage at the death of his mother, Shinichi grabs a kitchen knife and is ready to face the monster when, dun dun dun, it's Shinichi's mother. She's back. Not really. Shinichi, in denial, refuses to let Migi attack, and bam! We have our 134th kill with Shinichi Izumi, the main character of this series? Episode 6, The Sun Also Rises. Okay, so no one dies in this episode. Good job, everyone. Full marks, pip pip, cheerio. But just so you know what happens, let's go. Thanks to Migi, who gives the best CPR medical care, Shinichi is indeed alive. After some replacement heart surgery, he gets a call from the hospital that his dad is okay. So Shinichi goes into the countryside to protect his dad because the car crash parasite is seeking to kill him and Shinichi. After some quality father and son moments, Shinichi stays a night at a nearby hotel and stays outside the hospital to guard his dad. Later, Migi senses one of his kind, and Shinichi starts numing and also jumps high as sh- to confront the parasite. Who is this parasite? Will Shinichi get his revenge? And will that in-girl get a date? Next time on Parasite, The Maxim. Episode 7, A Dark Knight's Passing. Now it's time for the beach episode. Shinichi confronts the parasite, and surprise, it's someone just like him. His name is Uda, and this dude has a parasite living in his mouth, jaw, neck area. Shinichi and Uda talk, and afterwards they team up to defeat the car crash parasite. At night, we learn two side effects of Migi's surgery on Shinichi. First, Migi now has to rest for 4 hours a day, and second, 30% of his cells now swim around Shinichi's bloodstream, turning Shinichi into Shinichi 2.0. This comes in handy because the next day, Uda spots the car crash lady parasite, and the fight begins. Shinichi runs to help Uda when Migi is falling asleep. Just before Migi passes out, though, it turns into a sword. Thanks, Migi. At first, it seems like Uda's number 134th in this list, and Shinichi is about to be 135. But psych, Uda and Joe are still alive, and our actual 134th death is the car crash parasite, death by Joe. After the battle, Shinichi and his dad head back to the city, and we see that 30% Migi and the whole killing a monster that looks like your mom thing has turned Shinichi into a Chad. Cue the piano ending music. That's my impression of the piano music. Episode 8, Freezing Point. Episode 8, and straight out the gate, we have bam, bam, two deaths. 135 is obviously the person being eaten, and then the 136th death we have. Okay, so the host of this parasite name is unknown, because later this parasite says it recently settled on the name Shimada Hideo. So, yeah, we don't know the host's name, so RIP to you, Shimada Hideo's host. Death by parasite infection. And RIP to your name, I guess. Hanging with the Shimada parasite is Ryoko, back at it again at Crispy Parasite. She tells Shimada to study Shinichi, as he is important for the future of the parasite species. Back at the Shinichi household, Shinichi has basically become the Terminator or something. He has super strength and has lost his sensitive emotional side. For example, my man tries to dump a dead puppy he finds in the trash because a dead dog is just a lump of flesh. Also, rip puppy, death by car, I think. At school, Shinichi learns that there is a new transfer student, the parasite Shimada Hideo. He approaches Shinichi and tells him he's fine. You know, he hasn't eaten anyone. He's just here to coexist with the humans. Hey, what gives, baby? Psych, nope. He just changes his face and eats this poor lady number 3, taking our total counter to 138. Death by Shimada Hideo. Episode 9, Beyond Good and Evil. All right, a lot goes down in this episode, but there's only one death right at the end. So I'm just going to condense the rest. The investigators meet with Shinichi's dad and tell him to keep the whole murder parasite thing on the down low. One of Shinichi's classmate and friends, Yuko Tachikawa, sees Hideo get a nasty bump, like a literal indent on his head, and realizes he might not be human at all. Later in the day, Mitsuo and the Revolution decide to beat up Hideo, who can easily kill them all. Migi senses this and warns Shinichi, who intervenes to save Mitsuo and the Funky Bunch. Over to Yuko's perspective, we see her following Hideo because now she thinks he's a monster, and yep, the dude just changes his whole face. So the logical thing to do is to confront him about it in school? Really? Really, Yuko? That's your move? Anyway, she at least arms herself with some paint thinners, so, you know, nice one, I guess. Oh, this one's real nitpicky in a way, but I'm gonna shabang another death to this list. The 139th death goes to whoever Hideo eats, because he only changes his face to go and have his dinner meal. So, yeah, rip to you, some random person. Death by Hideo.
Episode 10, What Mad Universe.
Alright, episode 10, Hideo is about to kill Yuko when, psych, Yuko throws the paint thinner and crits Hideo, inflicting poison damage on him. Yuko survives, but slice, slice, and slash, we have the 140th, 141st, and 142nd deaths with two rugby high schoolers and one teacher. There's another school evacuation and class 3-3 is in danger once again. Before it was with Mr. A, and now it's Hideo. Actually, now that I think about it, in my last kill count video, which was the anime Another, the cursed class there was also class 3-3. Whoa, class 3-3 can't catch a break. Shinichi heads back into the school to rescue Murano, and alright, let's pause this and count the bodies. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Rest in pieces, death by Hideo. Shinichi finds Murano and two other students. He tries to escape with them, but bam wham, we have the 152nd and 153rd deaths, the two class 3-3 students. Shinichi, wasting no time, escapes with Murano. Back in the school, the police are fighting with Hideo and slice, 156th death, policeman number 1. Right after that, another slice, followed up by one more slice. Rip, policeman 2 and 3. A firefight ensues and the rest of the police in that shootout get killed by Hideo off screen. We see 3 policemen before, so that brings our count to 159. Shinichi decides to kill Hideo, so he gets on the rooftop of a random building using his and Migi's power and the rock. Wabam, Shimada Hideo. Death by rock. With the chaos over, Shinichi returns home and listens to the news. Bam, bam, bam. I'm adding 3 deaths here because, okay, the news says 17 casualties. I'm gonna assume they didn't add the police casualties in the reporting because if you add up all the dead students, teachers, and police, the count goes up to 20. But if you just add the students and teachers, it's 14 deaths. So I'm gonna assume we don't see the extra 3 deaths. So RIP, 3 students and or teachers killed off screen by Hideo. And that pretty much wraps up this episode with 24 deaths. That's currently the most deaths on screen, by the way.
Episode 11, The Blue Bird.
Starting this episode off and already with 3 deaths. Poor girl number 4, death by, I don't know who exactly, but one of those two killed her. And salaryman number 2 and salary lady number 1. Death by parasite infection. Now, the first chunk of this episode is the Great Kana's parasite psychic adventure, so we'll skip over that. We gotta get to the big kill count moment for this episode. The scene changes to a man in a singlet getting out of a car and heading to the local Yakuza building. He talks to the doorman and palm, 167th death, Yakuza number 1, death by muscle singlet man. Inside the office, smack, whap, baff, 3 Yakuzas on the ground, bam, this dude is killed off screen, and kablam, 1 Yakuza go through a door and passes on to the next life. Then, muscle man walks in calmly and swoop, jumps and knees this guy, bam, grabs purple suit's head and rip, then pretty much teleports in karate chop, choppity, chops 3 dudes. Next up, boom, sword man gets handed to his heart, followed up by slam, glasses gunman gets rammed up a china cabinet. After that, bam, punch, crunch with an instant crack. Finally, a dude gets a sword strike in, but stab, he gets hit with his own sword shard. Then muscle man does a slam, jam, whatever. Finally, slice, slice, the 2 final kills in this massive battle, ending with 22 deaths, all from the big muscle man. After the massacre, the singlet man runs away and a few pedestrians try to do a citizen's arrest or something, but swoop! Yep, that didn't work out too well for the Salaryman 3, who is now our 189th death. Oh yeah, gotta add Tank Top Man and the driver to this list, death by parasite infection, of course. A new day dawns and Shinichi and Murano are on a date. They go to a movie and what the hell? Why would you advertise a movie being 2D? Next day, Shinichi is meeting up with Kana, and on his way he comes across 8 parasites. What's more shocking than 8 parasites is that one of these 8 parasites is running for mayor. Dun dun dun! So let's add 6 deaths to the kill list. Now, it's 6, not 8, because the driver dude and Tank Top Man, well, they're also on that van podium. So, we got the dude running for mayor, long-haired lady, short-haired lady, glasses dude, and 2 more below, all death by parasite infection. And that's all for the death for episode 11 with a whopping 34 deaths. That puts it in first place for most on-screen deaths in a single episode, beating the prior champ, episode 10.
Episode 12, Heart.
Episode 12, and Shinichi spends 2 days trying to convince Kana not to follow her parasite senses, because it could literally lead to her death. After having a talk with Migi, Migi agrees to show itself to Kana to protect her, and they plan to meet up tomorrow at the train station. Next day, Migi senses 2 parasites. They see the most aloof-looking couple, and bam bam, 2 deaths are added to the list. Aloof dude and aloof lady, death by parasite infection. While this was happening, Kana gets the biggest brain idea to leave her phone and go seek out Shinichi using just her parasite senses. Anyway, Shinichi wanders around until Migi gets a signal. There's another parasite nearby. Kana has also felt the signal and follows it until dun dun dun, it's not Shinichi as she expected, but a random Salaryman parasite eating some poor victim. There you have it, deaths 200 and 201st, Salaryman number 4's human host and his victim. The Salaryman number 4 parasite attacks Kana, and just as Shinichi walks in to save the day, yikes. In a fit of rage, Shinichi wall slam jams the Salaryman parasite into becoming our 202nd kill. Salaryman number 4 parasite, death by Shinichi. Back to the sad moment, Kana says her final words to Shinichi and slump. The 203rd death belongs to Kana Kimishima, death by Salaryman number 4 parasite. We see the aftermath of Kana's funeral and cue sad piano ending theme once again.
Episode 13, Hello Sadness.
Starting this episode off, and we see the parasite committee having a meeting. So let's do a quick roll call for our kill count. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. I'm going to minus the standing guy, that's the mayor, laptop boy is the driver, center chair's former muscle man, and short hair, I'm going to say, is the lady from before. So that leaves, bam, this guy, long-haired lady number 2, old guy, and 2 parasite heads, 5 deaths, all from parasite infection. We also see that Ryoko has ordered a private eye to investigate Shinichi, and one of the nights the PI ends up seeing and recording Shinichi talking with Migi. Migi sees the man and tries to add him to the kill list when Shinichi saves his life. What will happen? Will Shinichi become a lab rat, or will Shinichi be able to discover who is watching him, breathing heavily?
Episode 14, The Selfish Gene.
So, spoiler alert, this episode has 0 deaths, so I'll just do a quick rundown. Shinichi calls Uda and they decide to investigate the private eye. The hunter has become the hunted. Well, he was being hunted by Migi before too, but you know, you get what I'm saying. We learn more about the PI Kuramori. We learn about his family life and how he wants to break the big case, like his favorite mystery novels. He then gets kidnapped by a high schooler and some dude, and Shinichi tells Kuramori the whole recap of all 14 episodes. They also tell the PI that his client is a parasite and is most definitely Ryoko Tamiya, now going by the name of Reiko Tamura, who later that day happened to call Shinichi to meet up. They meet and the episode ends with Reiko tormenting Shinichi's PTSD, and then Shinichi scaring the ever-living shit out of a fortune teller.
Episode 15, Something Wicked This Way Comes.
Episode 15 starts with Kuromori's assistant, who is now trailing Reiko. He sees this jacket dude hanging with Reiko and decides to follow him, only to see the aftermath of the jacket dude's meal. Then, crack, we get 3-in-1 deaths. First death going to jacket dude, death by parasite infection. Then poor lady number 5 and private eye guy, death by jacket dude parasite. Kuromori then asks for Shinichi and Migi's help, and they end up at the designated parasite kill spot. Basically, it's a, you know, BYOM, you know, bring your own meal restaurant. Anyway, Shinichi and Kuromori ends up witnessing two deaths in this count. Slice Poor Lady number 6, death by Salad Man number 5, parasite, and Salad Man number 5, death by parasite infection. Shinichi and Migi then steps out and Slash adds one more death with the 214th kill, Salad Man number 5, parasite, death by Migi and Shinichi. After watching that intense bloody battle, Kuromori decides to call a high school kid a monster and also calls it quits. In the parasite committee meeting, since Shinichi has killed one of their own in their restaurant, they decide to retaliate by sending a parasite named Miki. Also, the former muscle tank top guy, his name's Goto. Just wanted to put that out there. At school, Migi tells Shinichi that there are three parasites coming after him. Shinichi runs away and comes face to face with Miki, who turned out to be the dude parasite from earlier. And it's got three parasites in one body. Dun dun dun. Episode 16, Happy Family. Straight away, we get two sad deaths to the count. Rip Kuromori's daughter Yumi and his wife Yoko. Death by parasite from the parasite committee. Back to the fight. Shinichi and Migi at first struggle to fight Miki, but after some big brain moves, Slash, they get the 217th kill. Nope. Turns out Miki was just the right hand of the original parasite in control, the head honcho controller of five parasites, Goto. Now, at this point, you might think we should minus one death, because Miki is Goto, but hold on. In the side story manga, Parasite Reverse by Oda Moare, you find out that the original Goto used to be Miki, until a stronger parasite comes around, decapitates Miki, and then forces it to become its right arm. Then, the stronger parasite takes over the head and becomes the new Goto. So, Miki, aka the original Goto, had a human host as well that it killed. You got it? You got it. All right. The fight continues, and after getting hit by a truck, Goto needs a quick snack, so chomp, we get our actual 217th kill with a dash of 218th with the two truck delivery guys. Death by Goto. Meanwhile, Kuromori is a broken shell of a man and swears revenge on Reiko. The episode ends with three parasites in the parasite committee surrounding Reiko, ready to kill her. Episode 17, The Adventure of the Dying Detective. Reiko's battle begins and she detaches some of her cells, injects them into Old Man Parasite, and kablooey, we get our 219th kill, Old Man Parasite, death by Reiko's chestbuster. Using a chestbuster, Reiko corrupts long-haired parasite number 2 to fight driver parasite, and slice, long-haired parasite number 2 goes down, death by driver parasite. Oop! Another slice, driver parasite bites the dust, death by sneaky Reiko. After 1v3ing, Reiko discovers that Kuromori has kidnapped her baby and left her a note telling her to meet him at a park. Reiko then tells Shinichi to meet her at the park, and now everyone is just at this park. Kuromori then faces off Reiko with her baby, and just as he's about to kill her infant, stab. The police then arrive and Kuromori tells the head detective Hirama a description of Reiko and passes away. Rip Kuromori, death by Reiko. Police are now in search for a lady in white with a baby, and Shinichi meets up with Reiko at the park, and that is the end of episode 17. Episode 18, More Than Human. Episode 18 kicks off with Reiko talking to Shinichi, and she admits to having killed 38 beings. Alrighty, that is a quick 33 deaths, subtracting 5, because Mr. A, Ryoko's mom, long hair parasite, driver parasite, and Kuromori have already been counted. Reiko ponders motherhood while being shot at by the police, and she hands Shinichi her baby, then bang, she succumbs to her wounds and becomes the 256th death. Death by police. Shinichi, after having a good cry, gets interviewed by detectives and put to a test involving Uragami, who was the serial killer from episode 1. And he supposedly has the ability to sense parasites. Uragami stares at Shinichi and...
Episode 19, In Cold Blood.
So the staring contest continues and we get Uragami's backstory, and stab, the 257th kill, Poor Lady number 7 is killed by Uragami. Then we see Poor Lady number 1 dying again, and while having a terrible haircut, he sees a parasite taking Poor Lady number 8 to the parasite restaurant, and chomp, Poor Lady number 8 is placed on this list. Death by dude parasite, and the 259th death is dude himself, death by parasite infection. Staring contest ends, day passes, and the police go into full attack mode, creating a whole task force to eliminate the parasites at the Mayor Hirokawa's office. Today is the day. The anti-parasite task force surrounds the mayor's office, and using their high-tech sensors, they spot a parasite, and bang, we get short-haired lady number 2, death by parasite infection.
Episode 20, Crime and punishment.
36 seconds into the episode 20 and bang, shotgun blast to the heart and short-haired lady number 2 Parasite is killed by the Anti-Parasite Task Force, which I'll call AP for short.
Alright, there's gonna be a lot of deaths here, so I'm gonna go through them real quick, and to save time, when I mention a parasite, that's 2 deaths. Back at the mayor's office, we get bam, 2 deaths with Salaryman number 6 and Salary Lady number 2,
death by parasite infection.
The AP member continues the operation and bang, random dude gets shot, then slice, an AP member is out, then blam blam, Salaryman number 7 parasite and short-haired lady number 1 parasite gets shot. Salaryman number 6 parasite decides to Donkey Kong throw people around and kablam, random dude number 2 is dead, slash, random dude number 3 gets chopped, and slash number 2 rip another AP member. After getting 2 kills, bang, Salaryman number 6 parasite is out. Big Boss Yamagishi comes in and tells everyone to stay down. Random dude number 4 doesn't stay down and rip. Also another rip to that random dude number 5 over there. It looks like he got shot by the AP. Later, Salaryman number 8 parasite picks up Glasses Man here and bang bang, we get 3 deaths. Inside Mayor's office, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 bodies, 7 AP and 3 parasites, bringing our count to 290. Then bang, Yamagishi shoots Salaryman number 9 parasite, adding 2 more deaths. As the operation continues, bam, here in this slide we have 3 dead bodies. Random dude number 7, Parasite Lady, and AP number 9. Zam! Next slide, there's a big mouth parasite, and I'm gonna say this, but is random dude number 8, cause Yamagishi's talking about how he isn't here to protect civilian lives, so it seems to, you know, correlate with what he's saying. Third slide, bang, we have Salary Lady number 3 parasite. I don't think that AP guy's dead. Let me know in the comments if you think he's dead, cause I think he's fine. And finally, last slide, wham, there's 2 AP, 3 random dudes, and Salaryman number 10 parasite dead on the ground, bringing the count to 308 deaths. Slideshow over and we're nowhere near done. Bang, Salaryman number 11 parasite is killed by AP forces, and just when we think the anti-parasite squad is about to have an easy win, Goto appears and decides to bam, ba-bam, zam, slam, and damn all 5 AP members. We're now up to 315 deaths. Finally, this intense high death count episode ends with the AP pointing their guns at the big dog, Mayor Hirokawa. Episode 21, Sex and Spirit.
Episode 21 begins and Mayor Hirokawa goes on a passionate rant about how humanity sucks, and bang, Hirokawa is shot. But surprise, Hirokawa is human. Now, you might think I should remove Hirokawa's host death and the count before, but I don't need to do that because there were still 8 parasites at the mayor campaign speech. All I need to do is just change death number 192 to random campaign staffer. Later, Detective Katsumata lets his guard down and kablooey, he's blasted away by Uragami, and bam, as we can all guess, the 5 AP members have been wiped out by Goto. In the hallway, whoosh, 5 more members of AP make it to the death count, death by the Goto blender. Stabby, add 2 more AP members, and this off-screen, bam, extra 2 AP members killed by Goto. After a short firefight, dun dun, big man Yamagishi is our 332nd death. All death by the absolute madman Goto. The intense anti-parasite task force versus Hirokawa gang has ended, and Goto is the winner winner. Chicken dinner. Before Goto leaves, he tells Shinichi that he will kill him and Migi, and just hops out. Literally. Fearing for his life, Shinichi nearly gives up on living until he has the big sex, and then, yep, he's back, ladies and gentlemen, ready to take on Goto.
Episode 22, Quiescence and Awakening.
Straight out the gate, Shinichi commits Grand Theft Auto and the chase is on. At the forest, a long-awaited rematch begins, and slice, Migi decapitates Goto. Nope, he's fine, and we actually say a tearful farewell to the best right hand, Migi. Death by fading out. Shinichi, wounded and right armless, gets the help of an old lady named Mitsuyo, and several days pass until bam, we get our 334th death, a random hiker named Kirayama. Death by a beast? Nope.
It's Goto.
Shinichi, feeling guilt about bringing Goto to the neighborhood, decides to set off to face Goto and get revenge for our parasite Migi.
Episode 23, Life and Oath.
Shinichi is ready
He is determined. He comes across Goto in hibernation mode and armed with the rusty machete, he chop and fails to kill him. Goto, now in beast mode, beats the shit out of Shinichi until stab. Goto is hit with a rusty pole and takes poison damage. Angered, Goto tries to kill Shinichi, and after some quick thunder and lightning, Migi is back, baby. So, minus the 333rd death, Migi is a-okay. After a quick hey, Migi decapitates Goto and kablooey. Goto is our 334th kill. Death by Migi. Goto is still alive and is trying to revive itself. After having a monologue about the nature of parasites, the meaning of life and earth, Shinichi is the one to kill Goto, bringing the end of episode 23. Episode 24, Parasite. The final episode is here and we find out that the parasites aren't that hot of a topic anymore and that the killings have died down. No pun intended. We actually get a real quick death here. Bam, this random suit of dude with death by a parasite infection. At the Shinichi household, while Shinichi is asleep, Migi says its farewells via Shinichi's dream. Turns out Migi really liked it when he was absorbed by Goto and didn't have to think or do anything. Just exist. So Migi decides to just go into full hibernation mode and tell Shinichi, just imagine this was all a dream. Time passes and Shinichi is living a happy life and failed his college exam. Yikes. He once again has a nice monologue reflecting on this thing we called life and chomp. We actually get a National Geographic kill with the zebra death by lioness. Anyhow, back to Shinichi's date, things are going well until it's Doragami. He's back. He's taken Murano hostage and slice and stab, he kills two office workers, and after an intense face-off, Shinichi KOs Doragami and goes to save Murano when bam, is Murano our 340th death? No. Migi makes a quick unseen return and the Parasite series ends with Shinichi and Murano having a nice giggle while there's two dead bodies next to them. Seriously, they're dead. Why are you laughing? Transition to Mother Earth and fade to black. Alrighty, whew, that y'all, that was the entire kill count of Parasite the Maxim. Okay, I finished all of this recording beforehand, but I realized this crucial part. I have to add this in. I have to remove 9 deaths. As we all remember, episode 20, there was a bunch of deaths at the mayor's office, but I never took into consideration the 9 mayor staffers and Parasite committee members we met before in episode 11 and 13. Now, I feel it's safe to assume all 9 were present that day, because I'm sure parasites don't take vacation time. So, with all that out of the way, the final total kill list is a whopping 329. Now, that is spooky, let me tell you. A few quick fun facts. The most deaths in one episode was on episode 3 with 110 deaths, but the most on-screen deaths in one episode is episode 20 with 46 deaths. This is with the 9 subtracted, by the way. Thank you so much for watching this long ass kill count, and please check out our previous kill count of the horror anime Another, and subscribe and check out our other videos. Also, be sure to watch Parasite the Maxim on Crunchyroll.com. Seriously, it's a good anime. Just check it out. And finally, before I go, let us remember this great series that is Parasite the Maxim with this fantastic comment on the last episode from Crunchyroll user ThugLifeMiggy. Hope this user is doing good. Anyhow, with all that said, hope y'all have a safe and happy Halloween. And a farewell.
That is right. Get out. Get out the video. Watch the other stuff. Bye-bye now.